Where do you stand on the Statehouse renovation?
Well, I filed suit on Friday.
Outstanding.
Because the actions they took, first of all, the Statehouse Joint Management Commission leased the Statehouse.
Right.
They don't have the authority to lease out the Statehouse, and nor should anybody have the authority
right.
to lease out the Statehouse. It doesn't belong to them, and they shouldn't lease it out. But you know, the whole notion that they can go through this elaborate made-up transaction so they could avoid accountability to the legislature, so
yeah.
they could avoid accountability to the voters, is at the essence of why many people have started to not trust government.
And yeah.
They view the actions taken with suspicion, and rightly so, because
yeah.
this is clearly an end run around the document, the Constitution, and nobody should be allowed to do an end run. Think
yeah.
about this. Just imagine if this was like a home renovation project.
Yeah.
The contractor came in and said, all right, I'll do that for $38 million. And then when the project started, they said, oh, wait, there's been a change. It's now $750 million.
right.
You know, you'd have the Consumer Fraud Act. You'd have
yeah.
legal protections. You'd be able to go and do something about it. The people of New Jersey need the same kind of protection.
Tell me what was behind this lawsuit.
Well, thank you, Bill. And you know what? You know, I have an obligation to represent my 225,000 constituents. And, you know, yesterday I met with, obviously, Senator Lesniak and spoke to Senator Daugherty on the phone. And we got together and we actually filed a lawsuit because, you know, after the Lance Amendment, you know, we thought it was very clear that you couldn't go out and spend this kind of money without either the legislature being involved or voter approval. So we filed a lawsuit yesterday seeking, you know, injunctive relief. And, you know, hopefully we'll have a declaratory judgment. Hopefully we'll get before the judge.
Do you feel among your colleagues, Kip, that if this gets thrown back to the legislature, that there's enough strength in there to say, hey, we're going to shoot this down and go back to square one at the $38 million, which we already authorized, and start with that?
Well, absolutely. And you've seen, and I've heard on your station, you know, several of the candidates for governor have expressed their
yep.
opposition. The lieutenant governor has expressed her opposition.
Yes.
You know, several senators and assemblymen came up to me yesterday. They've expressed their opposition. So, yeah, I think that there's a consensus out there that this needs to come back for review. And,
yeah.
and let's do it the right way. And listen, if you can justify it to the public, then so be it. But I don't think you can.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Amen. Real quick.
And now this scheme of a $1 lease between the Statehouse Commission and the Economic Development Authority. What's your take on this?
The people of New Jersey, Bill, own the Statehouse, and the lease arrangement with EDA, in my judgment, is spectacularly inappropriate. And
what's your overriding feeling on this? Do you feel that, hey, this is just kind of how Trenton works, or is there some level of disappointment that the voters, year after year, there's this disappointment that the politicians seem to be working against us and not with us?
Clever lawyers might be able always to devise some sort of a loophole on any matter, constitutional or otherwise, but this is clearly an issue where I think the voters should be asked for their
yeah.
approval, and there should be greater specificity as to how much money is being spent and how precisely it's being spent.
Yeah. What about this charade that's going on? I mean, I see the boarded up windows now. I know your staff has been relocated for the most part.
Not for the most part. I'm out.
Wow.
We're done.
How about
We're
that?
Completely packed up. All of the furniture will be completely moved. There'll be a period there on Thursday or Friday of this week where we will not have computers set up because we have to flip them over to the other site, which is down the road about maybe three blocks.
Yeah.
And the government, at least at the Secretary of State's office, will be turned off
wow.
during the day. How smart is that?
Let me ask you, what happens? I mean, let's just go down the road a bit, just so people are absolutely 100% clear on your position. You become the next governor. This stops.
Period.
Good.
I mean, that's the only way. Unless we get injunctive relief right now, there is no other way to stop this. What I'm hoping is that the Senators Kip Bateman and Ray Lesniak and Michael Dorney have filed also for injunctive relief, because we're going to be so far down this road, you'll gut the Statehouse, and then there won't be any alternative. We'll have to come back. You'll have to finish it.
Yeah.
Unless we change governor.